So, let me start the history of the systems of the apart, the cryptography systems. Okay. So you can refer this textbook. Anyway, so let's look at symmetric cipher first. So we'll learn about the symmetric cipher, symmetric encryption decryption algorithm first. And then later, after midterm, we learn about the asymmetric cipher systems. So symmetric cipher system, there is a two part. There are two part. One is Alice A, so which is let's call Alice, and this is Bob. Okay, so Alice is doing the encryption, and Bob is doing the decryption. So Alice is receiving the message, which is called plain text, using key. So this key is shared with Bob. So we are saying that this is shared key. Okay, it's the same key. Then Alice is generating the ciphertext using this encryption algorithm. And on secret key K. So this is called ciphertext. Okay, then this ciphertext is moving to the Bob. Then Bob is doing the decryption using shared key K for this message. Ciphertext C, then it is generating the M prime, plain text. Then M is actually same to the M prime, right? So this is the symmetric cipher. And symmetric cipher, the K key value are equal in both sides. Okay, so let's look at the historical cipher systems. Okay, all of them is actually broken. Okay, so even though it's broken, we learn about that, how the historical cipher system was existing. So first we will look at the substitution cipher. So it's very simple. There is an alphabet. Then the key is actually mapping. Okay, so it's X and K. O, Z. Okay, so one point mapping. So this is key, this is key. Then encryption. Using this key for message, like for instance, bad. Then what is ciphertext? Can you type on the chatting window? What's the ciphertext? Yeah. So B is moved to M, E is Z, D is O. So ciphertext is M, Z, O. Okay, so this is ciphertext. Okay, what about the decryption? Okay, Ju. That was the decryption. Yeah, decryption is the opposite, right? So output is Z, input is E. O is D. That's the decryption. Right? Decryption of M, Z, O. Definitely it is B, E, D. Right? Encryption of C, A, D. Cat. Then what's the output? Cipher text. is kx. Okay. So this is a substitution cipher. So substitution cipher case, each character is substituted by another character. That mapping is key value. Okay. So then what's the size of key space? So how many keys, how many key can be possible? So A to the G. This is one key, right? So this is possible. This is possible, right? So then how many cases can be possible? Is it 26 factorial, right? Because from the mapping, A can be mapped to the 26 cases. After fix, B can be 25 cases. C is 24 cases. Z is one case. So 26 factorial. So 26 factorial is a very large number, right? It's large. It's very large. So it looks okay, right? It looks secure. But actually, it is not. We look at how we can break these systems, okay? So since 26 factorial is large enough, but actually this one is not safe. Another one is, let's look at the Caesar cipher, Cassara cipher, Caesar cipher. It's more simple. Key is just number, okay? So Caesar cipher case, it is shifted by key. So this is key. Okay, so for instance, key is, K is 3. In that case, encryption, so K is 3, H, Y, U. Then what's the ciphertext for that? So we are applying the plus 3 for each character. So A, so in this case, A is going to the D. B is okay. So this is H is K, Y is level round. So Y, Z, A, B. So 1, 2, 3. So Y is equal to the B. U is X. So that's the Caesar cipher. It's very simple, right? So Caesar cipher case, we are just adding the key value. Then what's the key size of Caesar cipher? How many cases can be possible? Alphabet case, alphabet has 26 characters, right? So the possible case is plus 1 or plus 2, plus 26. 26 is actually plus 0, right? A plus 26 is just A. It's a level round. So the possible key case is 26. That's all. That's the possible cases. So Caesar cipher definitely is not secure because if we are trying to 26 cases, then we can easily decrypt it. So, but actually this Caesar cipher was used at the Caesar's era. Okay, so here substitution cipher case, 26 character case, the key space is 26 factorial, it's large, okay? Then 26 factorial is large enough, so it looks like a secure, but there is some attack for this substitution cipher. So the attack is frequency attack. So let's look at the common character, common letter in the English text. So among this XLEH, which is the most frequently appearing in the English text? Yeah. E is commonly appearing letter. So if we are using the frequency of English letter, then we have this kind of things. So E is appearing 12.7%. And T is 9.1%. A, 8.1%. And also two characters like HE, AN, IN, TH, these are appearing frequently. So even though we don't know the characters, but if we know the frequency, then we can easily construct original message. So for instance, look at this case. So this is a ciphertext using substitution cipher. So here we don't know what does it mean, right? It's very hard. But if we are counting each characters, then we know that this one, B is appearing 36 times, N is 34 times, U 33, P 32, C 26. Okay, so then maybe we know that. Okay, so B is actually substituted by E. So we can say that this is E. Maybe, and this is T and A. And if we are looking at the two words, then this is appearing frequently, then this is IN, AT, and three words, and this is THE. So using these informations, maybe we have tried several times, but we don't need to try 26 factorial types. So this is frequency-based attack. So we can hear substitution cipher case using this frequency attack. We can solve the things. Let me introduce about some novel. Do you know this novel, Golden Bug, Gold Bug, written by the Yay Poe, Elegant Poe? Do you have any chance to read this book? It's a very short story. Maybe, I think in Korean it is 황금충, 황금벌레. Is there anyone who read this book? No one? Then I am recommending you to read this book, okay? Actually, this book is affecting to the Treasure Island. You know the Treasure Island, right? Yeah. So anyway, Goldberg is on the novel of Goldberg. There is a ciphertext. The main character is obtained this ciphertext. And he is trying to decrypt this ciphertext without key value. And this ciphertext is actually a substitution cipher. So the main character was trying to do frequency attack. So he is counting all the characters, and then by sorting the frequency and mapping the characters, then finally, he got the original message. So it's not mandatory homework, but I am recommending you to read this gold book, okay? Read. A very short one, short novel. It's not mandatory, but I'm recommending you to read. Okay. Okay, so this is substitution cipher. Bisinella cipher, it is used in the 17th century in Rome. It is similar to the Caesar cipher. The only difference is that Caesar's uppercase, every character, every letter, we are applying the same key value, right? Like a plus three. Business uppercase, the key is kind of string. Okay, so here key is crypto. That's the key value. Then message is like, what a nice day today. So here C is like a plus three, right? So C is plus three. So three plus W is W, X, Y, Z. So it is Z. And R plus H, then you can compute what is it, right? So using the position is Z and Z. Okay, so this is a ciphertext. So is this more difficult, right? Because even though G is appearing many times, but each G is a map from the different key, right? In this case. So here, each G is actually mapped to the different original message because different key are actually used. Here, but this case still, we can break this business cipher using frequency attack. So how we can do that? First, we don't know the size of key string, right? So here the key string size is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 characters, 6 letters. So we don't know that. So first we are thinking that, okay, K size is only one letter. Then we are applying the frequency attack. Then maybe we cannot success this part. So we are failure. Then we are trying to increasing. So using the two characters, two letters. Then what we are doing is, we don't know what's the key, right? We have no idea about that. But anyway, if you're looking at the even other number position, these are just the same key value. If the key letter size is 2, right? So if K is 2, that means we don't know that, but K is 2 letters. So 2 letters, another 2 letters. Right? So using this part, they are using the same key value. So for that one, we can apply the frequency attack for the characters, for the letters. But maybe we are failing about that, because key length is not 2. So we are trying until we can find. So maybe 6 case, then every 6, we are applying the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we are applying every 6 letters, we are applying the frequency attack. So definitely in this case, the ciphertext length should be a little bit large enough, right? If the ciphertext size is small, then frequency attack is not working. Okay. So anyway, this is the visionary cipher. So this is also broken. And Lothar machine, it was used in the World War II. So Lothar machine is kind of machine. It's a lottery. So it's winding. There is a value message. And this is key. So if you are typing the key value, then rotor is moving. Okay, Water is moving, and then mapping is changing every time. So if you're pushing the button, then new substitution is applied. So it's more complicated to analyze. That's the rotor motion. So here, this is a single rotor. This is a German army was used using the Enigma machine. So Enigma has 3 to 5 rotor machines. Okay, so it's more complicated because the value, input value, is moving to the some mapping and complicated, and then this one. Next one, the rotor is changed. Rotor is changed, and you, even the same character, even the same character, because of rotor is changed, another character is coming up. Okay. So here, this case, the key size is 2 to the 18. So these days we have a computer system, so we can try the 2 to the 18 times trial. But when the World War II, there is no computer systems, so it is very hard to analyze it. Okay. There is a movie about this Enigma machine, which is Imitation Game. Do you have any chance to watch this Imitation Game? Is there anyone who watched this movie? No one? So everyone was working on the... Oh, okay, so there is a one person, one student. Okay, so this Imitation Game is about Alan Turing, right? Alan Turing. So maybe you know who is Turing. Turing is very famous for the Turing Award, right? Turing Award. So Turing machine. So he was inventing the computer systems at the time, automatic computer system, to solve, to attack that the rotor machines, Enigma machine. So actually he was successful to break the Enigma machine. So that's the reason why the British has an opportunity to defeat German army at the time. Anyway, so maybe if we have a time, I am recommending you to watch this Imitation Game also. Okay, so it was the ancient traditional cipher systems. Okay, but these are not based on the theory, so everything is broken. 1974, there is a standard, data encryption standard. We are calling that this DES. So it was standardized. And this one is used almost 25 years. So that case, the key size is 2 to the 56. So at the time, 2 to the 56 is a very large number, but nowadays, because of the performance of the computer system, 2 to the 56 is very small. It's not large enough, okay? So new standard was proposed, which is AES, Advanced Encryption Standard. So in the following block cipher encryption scheme, we will learn about this DES algorithm and also AES algorithm briefly. Okay. So these days, these algorithms are used. AES and SALSA 20, it is another one. These are symmetric key encryption. And AES case, key size is increased by 128 bit. So that means to the 128 cases. It's a very large number, right? 128 is very large. Or if you are you want to increase the key size, then the AS allowing that, you can use 196-bit or 256-bit more secure. So 2 to the 128 is actually a very large number. Even you're collecting all the atom in universe, the number of atom is less than the 100, 2 to the 128. Okay, so 2 to the 128 is a really large number. I think if you're reaching this 2 to the 128, you have to get the lotto 7 times consecutively. So that probability. So if you're buying the 6 times the lotto, then every time your lotto is selected, then you can achieve this 2 to the 128 probability. Okay, so anyway, data encryption standard and AES, we'll learn about that later. Before we are continuing about these cryptographic things, we will briefly review the probability. Okay, so we will just look at the probability things. Okay, first, we are defined some set, right? Universe set. It's a finite set. And normally we are giving this kind of notation. So that means it's a set. Each set is 0 or 1 with n bit. Okay. So for instance, u is 0, 1, 0, 1, 3. That means it is representing 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. So instead of listing all the cases, we are just simply that 0, 1, 3, that means it is representing 3-bit binary. Okay, so that set is represented like this. Probabilistic distribution, Hwang-Yul-Mpho, means for the universe, so all the set, there is a function P. Then the probability is mapping to the from 0 to 1, right? So for instance, what's the probability of x equal 0, 0, 0 or x equal 1, 1, 1? What is it? So there are eight cases, right? Among them, there are two. So the probability is a quarter. That's the probability. So that's the definition of probability. And definitely, if we're adding all the probability, then 1, right? So that's the probability. And uniform distribution. Uniform distribution means that if we are choosing one element, then the probability of that element is uniform. So for instance, x equal 0, 0. Normally, you are thinking that this property will be a quarter, right? 0, 1. That is also 1 quarter. So then in this case, we are saying that this is uniform distribution. And point distribution. Every case, only specific case, this one and the other case is zero, then we are saying the point distribution. So for instance, x equal 0, 0. That is one. And other case, zero. In this case, we are saying that this is point distribution. And distribution vector, simply we are just list up the probability, then it is distribution vector. So instance is uniform, then everything is the same. Right, so this vector is generally given. Then we have to find the event. Event. So event means event is a subset of universe. Okay. So it is adding all the cases. So for instance, U is 0, 1, and 3 bit. A is 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. In that case, what's the probability of A? Yeah. 3 over 8. That's the event. So this set A is called event. And definitely the universe set case probability is one. So let's look at the example. U is 8-bit binary, which means that what's the size of U? How many elements in the U? To the 8, which is 64. And let's define the event A, all X in U such that LSB is the least significant bit. So two least significant bits is 1, 1. Okay. So then what is the A? A is something, 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 1, 1. Okay, this case. So that means 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So how many cases? 2 to the it's 8-bit. So that's 6, right? So probability of A is total is 2 to the 8. And the size of number of A is 2 to the 6. That's the okay. You already know that. Okay, so union. For event, two event, the union of these two event should be less than the adding of those two events. You know that. And number of A1, A2 is number of A1 plus number of A2 minus number of A cup B. You know that, right? And this is not, this is more than zero. So definitely if we are removing this part, then this is larger, right? So A1 B is larger than A1. Okay, we are skipping about, so let's look at example. A1 is, last 2 bit is 1, 1. A2. Last 2 bit is most. So this is most. Most significant. The first 2 bit is 1. Okay. So A1 is something 1 1. A2 1 1 and something. Okay. So in this case, what's the probability of that? The first last 2 bit is 1 1, where the first 2 bit is 1 1, or simply probability of A1 or A2. Exact probability case we have to compute, right? But anyway, we know that this is definitely A1 probability plus A2. We know that, right? So what is A1's probability? The last 2 bit is 1 1. A quarter. And the first 2 bit is 1 1. It's also 1 quarter. So that we know that the probability of A1 or A2 is less than half or equal to half. Maybe the exact probability case we have to compute, but in some case we just need that the bound of the probability. Okay. Random variable. Random variable. Definition of random variable is a function. Function of from the set, from the element to the another one. So random variable is a function, okay? Function. So mapping. So example, x is n bit string mapped to the 1 bit. Okay, so this is n bit and this 1 bit. So for instance, this is input value, right? Input is n bit, and output is just extracting the last bit only, least last bit. So for instance, x 0010, then the value is the last bit is x 0110, then it is 0. So that function. Okay, so then we can say that probability of x equals 0, that means the mapping. One of the mapping is 0 case, so which means that we are giving some value here, right? Then the output will be 0. So how many case is generating the 0? Among the n bit string, half of them is mapped to the 0, right? Because half of the string last bit is 0. Half of the bit string is case last bit is 1. So it's the half. This one case also half. That's the random variable. So random variable, the function. And then let's look at the Juniper random. So random variable is a function. You have to remember that it's mapping. Uniform random variable case. So U is some set, like n bit string. So it's n bit binary. We are simply that all is taking from U randomly. Okay, so this is randomly and also uniformly. So we are writing this notation means R is randomly chosen from the set U. Okay. So which means that the probability of R is something is uniform. Is uniform. Then we are saying that it's uniform random variable. Okay, so let's assume that R is uniform random variable on 2-bit tree. So that means R is from 0001 1011. So one of them is R. So in this case, what's the probability of R equal 00? That is that. And also 0110 11. Everything is the same, right? So in this case, we are saying that this is a uniform lambda. So R is given, then what we are doing is we are defined X, okay? So X is R1 plus R2. In this case, what's the probability of X equal 2? The other meaning is probability of X equal 1, 0 in binary. So what is it? So when X equal 1, 0, which case? R1 is one zero means is two. When is it? R1 is 0. R2 is 2, or R1 is 1, R2 is 1, or R1 is 2, R2 is 0. Right? There are three cases. Is it correct? Then what's the probability of the first one? What's the first case? R1 is 0. That's the quarter, right? Because there are two bit string. So there are four cases. Second one is 2 also. And second one? Right. Third one? So that the answer is okay. Three over 16. Then what about the probability of X equal 3? So this is all 0 is 0, all 1 is 3. All 0 is 1, all 1 is 2. Everything, each one is 16. Yes, good, right? So that's how we are computing the probability. So we are just counting the, all the cases. Okay. And then we have to know about the randomized algorithm. So encryption case, we need this randomized algorithm. So randomized algorithm means, so first we have to know about the deterministic algorithm. Deterministic algorithm case, so A here. If we are giving the message, some input, then the output is always determined. Okay, for given message, the output is fixed. Always. So then in this case, we are saying that this is deterministic algorithm. So almost every algorithm is deterministic, right? But when you're making the program, maybe your program will be randomized, right? In some cases working, and in some cases it's not working. So that is randomized algorithm. Randomized algorithm case, so this is given input, and there is a random. So whenever you are executing, new random is chosen internally. So new random is MB string uniformly selected, and using this value, output is generated. So instead of this notation, simply we are saying that here, A message given M, but with some random. So M is given, then, the output of this A will be one of them, uniformly distributed because of there is actually random part. So in general, A itself is deterministic. Algorithm itself is deterministic, but in the algorithm, it is using some randomized value, random value. Okay, so let me summarize. U is finite set, MB string, and probability distribution is from the universe to the 0 to 1 real number, and some subset. It's called event. Random variable is function from domain to the range. Okay. Independence. Event A and B are independent if the probability of A and B is equal to the probability A multiplied by probability B. Right, that's the definition. So independently is a chord. So let's look at the example. U is 2-bit string, and R is randomly chosen from the this 2-bit. Okay. So define random variable X and Y is mapping. It's a mapping function. For the X, it is returning the least significant bit, last bit. Y is most significant bit. In that case, what's the probability of X equals 0, Y equals 0? So how we are computing? So let's just compute, okay? So here, this means least significant is 0, right? what that means. This means the input is x. We are just giving r, then it is 0. And y to the r is 0, right? We have to come to this case, right? That means our last bit is 0. So something like this. And this case is the first bit is 0. This. That means 0, 0 case. So all is should be 0, 0. What is the property of this one? All is a uniform lambda. It is. Right, so the first part is quarter. Then what about the property of x equal 0? That is r is 0, 0 or r equal 1, 0, right? Which is f. Property of y equal 0. That is r equal 0, 0 or r equal 0, 1. It is also f. So now we know that this one is f and this one is also f. So the property x equal 0 and y equal 0 is equal to the x equal 0, property y equal 0. So x and y are independent. Okay. So sometimes, so here in this case, LSB and MSB, sometimes we don't know this A and B are independent or is dependent. We don't know. In that case, we have to compute the probability, then we know that this is independent or not. Okay. And in the encryption, we are using the exclusive OR many times. XOR. Symbolically, we will use this one, this XOR operation. So XOR operation, bitwise XOR operation means 0, 0, XOR is 0. 0, 1 is 1. 1, 0 is 1. 1, 1 is 0. Okay, so this is XOR operation. Then what's the result of 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1 XOR? 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. What's the output of this XOR? 0, 1 is 1. 1, 0 is 1, 1, 1 is 0, 0, 1 is 1, 1, 0 is 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0 is 1. So that's the result. Okay, so that's the definition of XOR operation. Okay. So then why we are using the XOR so frequently in the cryptography? The reason is, so look at this theorem. Y is a random variable, okay, random variable, MB string. X is independently uniform variable. So here, X is more better, right? This is uniform. What of the Y? Y is not uniform. So X is uniform, but Y is not uniform. So that means probability, so here probability X case, X is something, 0, 0. Then we know that this is a quarter. Okay, we can say that. But probability Y equal 0, 0, we don't know that. Okay. Because Y is not uniformly distributed. Maybe Y case 0, 0 is occurred more frequently than 1, 1. Okay, So y has some different distribution case. X has only uniform distribution. In the case, we are making z. Z is y x over x. Okay, so we are applying the x to the y using this x over. Then z is also uniform. Okay, so let us look at what is really happening. So simply, let's think about the one bit case, okay? Just a single bit case. So probability of z equal zero. So let's look at whether it is really half, okay? So we'll check it. So let's check about that. Okay, we know that z is y x over x, right? So that means probability y x over x is zero case, right? So when this is happening, there are two cases, right? Y x is zero, zero case, or y x is one, one case. Is it correct? Right? Zero, zero is zero x over zero is zero. One x over one is zero, right? So two cases case, z is zero, right? So then, these two cases are not relevant, so we can say that yx equal 0, 0 or yx equal 1, 1, right? Okay, so then let's look at the first case here. So let's look at the x and y. And so x equals 0, y equals 0, x equals 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So what's the probability of that, this case? So we have to compute this probability, right? This probability. So when this is happening, probability. So 0, 0 case, what's the probability of x? X and y are independent, right? X and y are independent. So what's the x equals zero probability? Half. What of the y equals zero? This is not half. We don't know, right? So we don't know that. We have no idea about that. This is half or it's not half. We don't know that. Okay. What of this case? F and y equal 1. This case, F, y equal 0. This is F, y equal 1. Okay? So we don't know that the probability of y equals 0. Okay? So anyway, y and x equal 0, comma 0, that is this probability. So F, y equal zero case, right? This is correct one. And what about the probability of next one? That's the last one here, right? F probability y equal one. Right? So this is f probability y equals 0 plus probability y equals 1. What about this one? It's 1. So it is f. So probability of z equals 0 is relevant to the probability of y. So if we are applying the XOR, then the output is just uniform distribution. So Z is Y XOR X. Then if this is a uniform, then independent of the Y, the output is also uniform. Okay, so that's the reason why we are using the XOR operation. So XOR is changing. Okay, XOR changing the distribution. Okay. So that's the reason why we are using the XOR operation a lot. And for the birthday products, actually, this is handled in the hash thing. So we are skipping this part. We'll talk about this. First parents later. Okay, so any question? Nothing? Okay, then see you on Wednesday. Bye.